Hey everybody, my name is Owen and
I'm Ulf Harkness,
and welcome to the video. Today we want to talk about sexuality and the difference between unhealthy, conditioned, undeveloped masculine, undeveloped divine feminine sexuality, and our relationship with ourselves and our partners, and healthy type of sexuality and intimacy. So,
and how to heal sexual wounds from unhealthy programming like porn addictions or need of visual stimulation for sexual arousal and things like that.
Yeah, so porn as well, like, so generally if you look at most relationships in the world, like, people aren't very deeply connected from the heart, and often intimacy is lacking too, and often trust is lacking, just overall intimacy, love, connection, so
intimate communication and
honesty,
truthful communication.
So basically the bottom line is you have to, like, heal yourself and to grow up, and you have to be honest with yourself and to study and reflect upon your own life, behavior, body language, words, action, everything. This is all part of spirituality, growing up and healing from our traumas and wounds and conditioning by the Illuminati or the bankers, like the corrupt people who control most of the wealth and power on the earth. So,
because if they can stifle your sexual energy, your creative life force, then they can control you a whole lot easier.
Totally true, yeah.
Yeah.
Totally true. That's what modern schools do too. They're built to build you the way they want you to be built as a person, like real, like robotic, like two-dimensional paper two-dimensional, like, being, instead of a creative, empowered, 3D, multi-dimensional being who knows themselves and loves, has unconditional love and open heart and everything else like that.
So making you ashamed of your sexual organs, making you ashamed of how you look, making you ashamed of your sexual wants and needs, as pure as they might be, and simply just shaming you for being a sexual being, a spiritual being in a human body.
A lot of the religions do this. They're part of the whole bankers control system, reptilian, etc. All these people who, they're changing, and the world powers are changing gradually, but they want us to be like little juvenile babies who are undeveloped and living in fear, easy to control, living in self-shame. And when we shame ourselves, we become like a regulating police force, because when we're programmed to be self-shamed of ourselves, our bodies, our looks, our sexuality, our sexual organs, then we then judge others too. So what we have ourselves, we project and put onto others. So if we think like it's rude or bad to masturbate, it's evil, it's unholy, or you're going to go to like spiritual prison, like, you know. It sounds so ridiculous and funny to me, like a humorous type of weird comedy, you know, black comedy. Then we'll enforce our own blockages and unhealed parts onto others. Like if we're brainwashed to believe hugging is wrong or masturbating is wrong, then we'll act like police, like judging and looking at others and telling others to not do this, and make them try to be ashamed if they do it. So it's a great like self-governing like police force that they make when you breed people to be like babies.
Let's say you were naked.
Yeah, naked.
And most people would think that you were insane. Or crazy, or in some cases you'll even get arrested for being in your birthday suit. And let's say you walk in the forest and you see somebody making love. Okay, well they're loving each other. And let's say you walk through the forest and you see someone making love to themselves. All of a sudden he's a pervert, he's a freak, or there's something wrong.
Like animals make love naked all the time. Animals are born naked, we're born naked, insects live their lives naked. It's the Illuminati reptilian bankers, like controllers, who try and make us like unnatural. And this video only talks about one aspect of unnaturalness on the earth at this time period of this type of government control. There's loads of different examples of unnaturalness.
We could talk for 2 hours.
Yeah, the more
at least if we were to take up everything that's unnatural on this planet. Yeah, like the I've learned here with Owen and them. All our food-like products are unnatural.
Yeah. The more you go away from nature, the more sick and unbalanced you get, and the more disharmony and disease and negative vibes you get.
All the chemicals that we put on our clothes to make them clean, and
on our bodies.
And on our bodies to supposedly make them clean and wash our hair.
Yeah, why are we told to wash all the time? It's like breeding us to think we're naturally dirty. We're only dirty when we take unnatural chemicals and toxins. We're not naturally dirty.
You're more dirty when you come out of the shower than when you've been going for a run and sweating out toxins for a half an hour, you know?
Yeah.
Madness.
Yeah. So anyway, yeah, sexuality, like, I guess I'd like to say, like, great relationships, like, are there when we heal and grow. And it's there for you for the taking in the future, but, or maybe even now you might be ready. But at the end of the day, you have to think about your role models and examples that exist in society. And porn is like the worst role model or example out there. Usually our parents, mixed type of role models, if they're really healthy. Most people are not healthy role models at all in a lot of our history because of what we've just talked about, like the bankers and reptilians, Illuminati, etc. On another planet, to put things in perspective, imagine they were all healed, pure beings, like living in accordance with nature, toxic free living mentally, emotionally, physically, then we'd be living in a group of good examples where we see real love, respect, honesty, affection, intimacy.
Most of us have grown up with role models that show toxic love, that show the unhealthy romantic attachment templates of love, which are being replaced on this planet now with divine love and divine unions and healthy non-attachment love, where you just simply love the person. You don't necessarily even have to be with them to love them. You just love the fact that they are alive and that they are in this world, and you're grateful for that, and you don't necessarily even have to own them or be with them. This sense of ownership on this planet,
it's very porn,
it's very, very toxic, and it's from the patriarchy. The men was afraid of the women's power, and so they did what they could to bring the women down. And I've been guilty of that in the past because I was also raised that way, with the media and my peers and the programming through television, religion, and all that as well. Where we slut shame women for embracing their own bodies, for example. I've been guilty of doing that in the past, and now I've come to realize that I was also afraid of being naked myself, and so I projected that fear and that inability to appreciate my own nakedness and my own body onto not only women but other men, and jealousy, insecurity, and all these things, very unhealthy energies I projected onto all my past lovers and onto other people.
Magazines are really good for brainwashing you too. They try and make you so uptight, thinking that like you have a crap body. We focus in on our nose, our eyes, our teeth, our
any
tummy, our breasts, or anything we think is an irregularity or not good. And then we think we're ugly, we're afraid to be naked. Like, I'm not even trying to promote like public nakedness, nothing like weird or unusual like that in the society that we live in. It would be considered weird. But I'm just talking about like being comfortable with your own body and not to be so self-obsessed. Like, the body is just a vehicle of, just the beautiful, divine, holy vehicle, the holy forest of like the living forest or vehicle of our spirit, you know. It's there just to live by our spirit. That's what the body's there for, and to enjoy also, to create. It's the what instrument of our soul, like, so to speak. In like, we have to let go of our insecurities, learn to heal, embrace, love, forgive, accept others, ourselves, not to be ashamed of, not to be too uptight, and not to do the opposite, which is like flaunt, flirt, and try and like to be competitive and be better than others. Yeah. That's all like shallow, ego, immature type of living. Yeah. So I really do encourage you actually to get like look in the mirror,
embrace who you are.
Yeah, and get comfortable with being nude in your house. Like if either if you live on your own or if just in general, like even if it's a sunny day and there's no one in your back garden and you feel you have enough privacy, just learn to try and embrace and love your body more. It'll really translate into a much healthier sexual relationship with your would-be partner or with yourself.
I will say this though, if you live with others, you should probably like warn them that you enjoy being naked in your own company when you're alone, because I've been like, yeah, so do that. Tell people that you enjoy some naked time and to feel free and explain to them what it's about, maybe not first and things like that.
Yes.
So, yeah.
But you don't have to intrude others, but yeah, you can do it in your own personal space is what I'm saying, you know?
Yeah, same.
Yeah. So,
I would also like to add one point about... it was about sexuality, which, I was trying to hold on to the thought, and then as it slipped away...
It'll come back.
It's about being... no, I can't find it.
Doesn't matter. I'll talk about porn for a second. Like porn teaches a terrible example of like male domineering of women and exploitation. It's like really gross, generally speaking. I don't recommend porn, and I recommend trying to gradually get off porn. Like unless it's like really the nicest, softest porn, like with a sense of intimacy, love, respect, which is like very rare to find. But even that, you know, you could all, depending on you, think of the vibrations and the love, respect, genuine between the people. But the hardcore porn or most porn is like just really, really terrible vibration. Really, really bad example on how you should be treating women, or how you as a man should, if you are a man, should behave also, or how what or to women the message is like how you should be treated also, yeah. Like have accept only the best in life and always what I'd say, regarding like where you live, your home, your environment, the people you hang out with, the people you spend time with, the people you allow into your company.
The people you allow into your body, not to say the least.
For sure, yeah.
That energy and be mindful of the people that you have sexual interactions with, because the people you become like the people you hang around, and more so the energy lingers for up to 7 years in the womb of the female, and the masculine energy remains with the woman. So you'll actually have to bring back that energy as a man, and the woman has to actually clean and heal her womb of these energies, as DNA also gets stored in there. Your future children will have DNA remains of all your past lovers, so that's also something to think about.
Nothing to get like super freaked out with though either, like it's still something
to think about, I think.
Yeah, definitely.
Especially for women. And
yeah, of course.
And with porn, it's also the energy that you bring to it. Let's say if you have an innocent energy and you watch not so innocent porn, you will have a different experience than someone who is totally toxic and
getting ready to exploit the next person they meet.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's also about the energy that you bring to what you're doing.
Yeah.
Let's say I've healed from sexual traumas a lot the past year, and what I found was that imagery and porn was not helping me heal or aiding me in any way in sexual relations. You have to have sex to actually have sexual healing. But still, I found a way that if you use your imaginative faculty once more, if you fantasize about your lover or about any set type of sexual relation or that's attraction,
more, yeah.
then you use your mind and you use your own visuals and your own energy and your source creative energy.
Yeah, it's kind of more graceful and gentler and
becomes
softer, isn't it?
A lot more pure, and it's only your energy that you bring to it instead of like bringing your innocent, pure, beautiful energy to a toxic porn video scenario. So you remain within that bubble of your own love of how and what you would love to do to a woman, how you would like to treat her. You fantasize about basically how you would treat a woman as a beautiful, pure, innocent being that you are, instead of having this male patriarch exploitive programming imprinted onto your own act of self-love, which masturbation actually is.
Yeah, and a lot of like ordinary sex between people is sort of like masturbating with a person rather than bringing in like deeper love and respect often. Not always.
Especially if there's no kissing, there's no intimate connection there. There's no build-up, foreplay, relating in any kind of way before the sexual act. It's just wham, bam, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, then that's kind of crap, plainly, for me, like, to be honest.
That's very toxic sexual relations, You'll feel unsatisfied. Mm. It'll be like eating a crappy meal. You'll still want the real deal after.
Mm.
And the same with porn, too. But if you fantasize, you'll feel much more fulfilled. If you're able to be intimate and open yourself, you'll be much, much more fulfilled. So it's basically your responsibility, what you want out of the bedroom, be clear, communicate, express your needs, express your wants.
And express what you don't like, too.
Yeah.
Listen, ask questions. Like, for me, the best lovemaking is an extension coming from intimacy and love. It's like the tree. Lovemaking comes like the branches, but they come from the trunk of the tree. So for me, sex is on its own is like almost nothing, like hollow. It's like no proper connection. Like, whereas making love, it's like longer lasting, and it's like full of like emotions, like positive emotions and love, care and respect and the kindness and
enjoyment,
warmth, enjoyment.
And pleasure. Learn how to receive and give in a balanced way.
Yeah.
And open up. And if you're not ready to open up, you shouldn't be having sex either. If you're not ready to look into your partner's eyes, you shouldn't have sex with them either. If you're not ready to kiss, you should not have sex, because it'll be a traumatizing experience for you, your partner, and you'll only add more traumas to your already existing traumas.
Yeah, like they say, it's easier like to have sex than to go into the intimacy of like kissing and looking in someone's eyes. Like, a lot of people won't kiss, but they might have sex.
Yeah.
And it just goes to show like the intimacy of like being close to somebody, and while a lot of our senses are in our head, and like just like so close, the breath, the heartbeat, intimacy is what it's all about. That's what I want to say. Like, go for intimacy, not sex. And that needs to be the right person, the right match. And you need to have the right relationship with yourself first, which is why we talk about healing and stuff like that at the beginning of the video. So I'd really, really recommend go for the gold, which is like a loving, intimate relationship. And then sex comes from intimacy. Yeah. Don't try and get intimacy without sex. Try get lovemaking and sex with coming from the love and intimacy, which is a lot of like maybe cuddles, hugs, snuggles, play, fun, smiles, compliments, praise, affection,
pouncing,
all this nice stuff, you know, first and even after a little bit too, you know. A lot of sex is like what Ulf was saying, like wham bam thank you ma'am, like just quick, like in, out, on, off, and then bye. And it's just like crap. It's a waste of time, in my opinion. I think it's just all like, it's not even like an animal. Animals are way better than a lot of like how humans have sex, which is humans are unnatural, animals are natural.
They partner for life, they look after the young ones, they take responsibility for what they bring into this world, they feed their young ones, they stay with their young ones until they're able to take care of themselves, which is something we could not pin on most parents on this planet. Mm-hmm. And yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, be responsible for your sexuality.
Yeah, honor your body. Don't just give it to anybody. And yeah,
like wait for the partner that will honor and respect you. Honor yourself and take responsibility for your sexuality, and be mindful and aware of who you're allowing into your body, and what kinds of energies you're mingling with. It's a good saying that I once heard. Mm. Don't have sex with someone you wouldn't want to be.
Yeah, it's a really good saying, and a brilliant saying. Yeah. And it reminds me of the saying, treat others like you'd like to be treated.
Yeah.
And also honor yourself, as Ulf was saying. It comes, how you honor yourself sexually, who you're with, also is an extension of who you honor yourself, of your friends and the positive family members you spend time with. So if you're going to spend time, if you're going to choose to be, instead of being a victim, take responsibility and say, okay, I'm choosing to spend time with these people. Instead of saying, oh, they're victimized, they're picking on me and abusing me. Say, why are you picking and abusing yourself by choosing to spend time with these people?
Yeah.
So sex relationships also comes from the people you choose to spend time with.
It starts with how you nourish your body and how you nourish your mind and temple. Because what I see often with these people that have toxic relations and are in and out of relationships and very, very toxic, they usually put toxic stuff in their bodies. They're around toxic people.
Yeah, exactly.
They have toxic families. Everything is toxic, and so their sexuality is also toxic.
Yeah.
So
clean up your life.
Clean up your life all over.
Yeah, yeah. Holistic.
As a way of being, as an agenda for yourself, is this meal healing? Are these people healing? Is this place healing? Is this sexual relation healing, or are you just acting out some animalistic urges that you have to have fulfilled right now?
They're kind of crap, in my opinion, just to speak bluntly. It's crap having a crap meal full of junk and toxins and crap stuff. Poor quality, like fake, unnatural, old food and all this stuff.
You're not loving or honoring your body. You're not loving or honoring yourself, your mind, body and spirit. And that's also how you should think when you're having sex. Are you honoring your mind, body and spirit with how you're allowing this person's energy into your body physically as well?
Drugs are crap. They give you a high and then a low. I just call them crap. They're crap. Temporary excitement and stimulation, or like the opposite, sedation. It's one or the other, and you just feel crap. Same with like food, drugs, all the processed crap food. Same thing, same with crap sex. It just leaves you lower in the long run and takes away from your life for the temporary buzz or this temporary sedation.
What you want is nourishment.
Mm.
What you want building. Is fulfillment and building your vibration and building your energy.
A long-lasting buildingness, not a temporary blah.
And it works so much better naturally, and I can testify to that, because I used to be a drug addict for 15 years, and my whole life was toxic, and now by entering into a more holistic mindset and adding less and less toxins to my life, nourishing my mind, body, and spirit way more than I ever thought possible, I'm now having a good life. I don't want to take drugs anymore.
Yeah.
I don't want to. I don't want to.
He's come such a long way, and I'm glad to see another person like growing up and taking responsibility and trying hard, and cleaning up their act and wanting to clean up the world.
Yeah, mature, and take responsibility for yourself and your surroundings.
Yeah.
And add that to your sexuality as well. And you'll be a much better person. I have sexual wants and needs and desires and urges like everybody else, but I refuse to have sexual relations with someone who is not healthy, that are not taking care of their body, and most of all, are not loving themselves.
Yeah, I couldn't stand having like casual sex with like.
I can't do it anymore.
So many people.
It just doesn't work for me anymore.
It has to be deeper.
Spiritual heart and mind connection there. If I can have all those those three, then yes, I will. Yeah. I will definitely consider having a sexual relation. But if any of those three are missing, then I really don't feel like it's appropriate for me. That it would be a beautiful experience that I could grow from.
Yeah. I'm feeling very happy now in my life, personally, individually. I don't need to be in a relationship. I'm happy to be single, but I'm actually not single. I'm in a relationship that is my favorite, best relationship of my life. My partner has like got a lovely body aligned with like nature and clean living, clean, healthy choices aligned with natural like food.
You can tell it from these guys' vibrations as well, that they're adding to one another.
We totally add all the time. We get on extremely well. Best sexual intimate relations of our both of our lives.
Two high vibrations. So good, like, come together like that. You get like twice as much.
It's so good. Like, I just, that's why I want Patrick Visa, I want to make the video. I feel inspired. I want to encourage you to clean up your act, clean up your life in all ways, but this video is about focusing more on sexuality. I want you to experience a joy of like love and intimacy before, and then sexual greatness will come from that. So just fulfillment and pleasure, balanced harmony, everything in all aspects of life.
Yeah.
Like, being in a good relationship is like so good, but all the hard relationships prepare you for being in a good relationship by bringing up your wounds and triggers and traumas from the past. So view your hard relationships positively, know when to let go, know when to keep learning. It's very, very important. When things become physically abusive, it's better than to like finally say goodbye. But always take responsibility and for your part of choosing and deciding everything that you do and say or don't do and don't say. So don't be just playing the victim or blaming someone too much, for definite. Just always look to improve. And
if you're being abused, you're allowing the abuse.
Yeah.
So, and take responsibility for what you're allowing in your life, as that will continue. Mental and emotional abuse is also not okay, and you should get out of that as well as fast as you can. No relationship or love in your life is worth being feeling mentally tormented or emotionally tormented in any way. That means you don't love yourself, and you should get out of the relationship and start loving yourself.
Yeah, and don't torment others. Like, take responsibility for your own abusive energy, which can be very subtle sometimes. Like, even if you feel upset or off or bad in some way, that's usually, we act on these emotions and triggers and start communicating, and usually that just creates like loads of conflict, loads of trouble or trauma, is what I'm trying to say. Not just a little minor petty disagreement, but if we have to take responsibility for our energy, not just our actions and words. Our actions and words come from our energy, our extension and coming from our energy. So when we feel emotionally upset and all that stuff, just be really, really careful about like choosing the right time to communicate. So if you're too frivolous and carefree with expressing yourself when you feel upset, annoyed, or angry or frustrated, it'll nearly always come across like wrongly or badly, and someone will feel your energy. It's a bad time. They won't listen to you, or else they'll react to you, and you're probably reacting already. So you should always try and fix your own energy first. So I guess what I'm trying to say is an extension of what Ulf said. Don't be abused, but don't be an abuser. Be careful of your own energy and take responsibility of your actions, words, and energy.
Once I started meditating, I ended my abusive cycle. So start meditating. Meditate on your heart. Get help with your emotional body and your pain body, so you won't experience as many triggers.
Get healing from him.
Take responsibility for your triggers, because they're your triggers. Nobody's triggering you. You're responding to your own triggers. So excavate your triggers.
Excavate.
And find them. And do some good soul searching and digging.
Yeah. Big time.
And meditate and cultivate your own peace. Peace of mind, peace of being, love in your heart, love for yourself, and you won't need it from anybody else, and you'll always have that centered, balanced, comfort place that is your own, that nobody can take from you.
Yeah, brilliant.
Especially in a relationship, that's so important.
More and more. do keep doing that, like massive life reflection and self-reflection, to see where you're going wrong and all of your poor choices and all your triggers and why you're doing everything and why you're not doing everything that you could be doing to make it better. And you should never want to be in a relationship to fill something in you that you feel terrible or like an unhealed trauma from the past. So the best place to be in a relationship is when you don't need to be in a relationship, because loads of people feel insecure, sad or lonely or whatever because of a childhood trauma, and then they rush, they're always rushing, they can never be single, they're always rushing to try and jump in with anybody, and that leads to disaster, as you already know. So you want to heal yourself first as much as possible, or if you do happen to resonate with someone who you think is pretty good for you, at least always work hard together for your own healing also. So you don't need a relationship, basically, is what I'm trying to say.
Because you won't find you won't find love in the arms of another, ever.
Or fulfillment or life satisfaction.
No, the only love that you will feel is the love that you have to bring to the relationship. So if you have no love for yourself, you give your partner the responsibility of loving you for you. And that's not a very good...
It's a weird energy, entanglement.
Yes.
They don't want to be your mother or father, like caregiver, and you don't want to be their baby or vice versa.
Yeah,
you want two grown-ups in a relationship, like two mature, healing, taking responsibility beings who are trying to be heart-focused, and they're trying hard to be heart-focused.
Yeah, and they're doing their best.
Yeah, you want like humble learners in a relationship.
Willing to take responsibility, willing to admit that they've done something wrong, willing to admit when they're at a fault or otherwise. And yeah, if both partners are like that, there can be major improvement and growth, even with a toxicity existing in the relationship. You can actually then communicate and heal away the toxicity if you're willing to meet halfway and communicate properly with one another.
Yeah. In a relationship, I think one of the best things to do is like say sorry, admit you're wrong, but also live in your heart. You have to live in your heart, and then you can invite others humbly to maybe be open to learning and learning from their mistakes or admitting their like.
It's a lot easier for people to open up if you're not like bossing them around.
Yeah,
I've
been
very guilty of doing that in the past. Like, I was very fast and quick to see other people's faults.
Yeah, yeah.
And
me too fast.
And then I learned to admit, like, wow, yeah, you're right. I did that. And I'm so sorry. I'm gonna work at that and then take some timeouts and actually, work on those wounds that create that behavior. It's really helped me in life. Now I have a healthy relationship with my mom.
We
haven't had an argument since this Christmas.
Yeah.
I have a healthy relationship with my
sister. We're really close to our moms, actually.
Yeah.
We've super similar pasts. But like, we're like soul brothers for sure.
Yeah.
Like super, super similar in so many ways. We can't get into it now, really, but we've got great relationships with our moms. We've come so far. We've minimized our arguments and disharmonies with people and our closest.
Try to admit our faults and grow and learn from our wounds, and then give that back to others and pay it forward.
Yeah. Cool. Is there anything else you'd like to say? Like, maybe, do you feel like wrapping up the video? Maybe Aaron.
Have 30 minutes. If you want to heal your sexuality, have 30 minutes a day where you practice self-love. Where you take care of your sexual organs, massage them, find the knots in the places, and learn more about your body. Because most of us are so alienated and scared and shamed.
I only learned that masturbation was like 16 or something crazy.
I watched my first porn when I was 18, 19, so...
Me, something similar.
I didn't... I always had a girlfriend, so I didn't feel that it was right to do so. It was, for me, that was cheating. So I never did that until I was like 25, 26. I didn't have a girlfriend anymore, and I was very, very ill and very, very sick and very, very lonely.
Me too, I got similar.
And then I started watching it, and it hurt my sexuality. Before that, I had no sense of hardcore porn or like being aggressive and sexuality, that was not anything that I had been taught or programmed with. I only knew love making. That was what I knew.
Yeah, that's better. I have no interest in porn anymore.
Yeah.
And surprise, we're in a different place now, and we're standing up. We forgot to say something.
Yeah. The thing about healthy sexuality is, of course, it starts with your hormones, with your endocrine system,
balance
in your body.
Yeah.
And if those are malnourished,
toxically irritated with like crap food,
stuffed with bad energies,
From eating from like McDonald's, Burger King, and like factory farmed dairy and meat.
Anxiety.
Terrible energy.
Anxiety, overload of your adrenals, fight and flight, not able to relax in your body, having healthy hormones and producing happiness and joy and good energies.
Yeah.
And being able to remove toxins out of your body, then your sexual life is probably also going to be crap.
Yeah, basically speaking, the more unhealthy your diet and lifestyle, the more unhealthy and functioning, the less functioning your sexual abilities will be. And a lot of people get like erectile dysfunction. And that's because they're basically, apart from emotional traumas, a lot of it's hugely got to do with like congestion of your capillaries to your penis. So that's got to do with eating like too much dairy and meat and fish, which is full of cholesterol and fatty tissue, fats that like stick to the inside of your arteries and veins and capillaries. So that's terrible. So you don't want to do that. So you want to nourish your endocrine gland system with like herbs and your adrenals, like what the Chinese call jing, which is your sexual energy, which is like the root. It's the kidney and the adrenals. At my herb shop, I have all of these like herbs like Hoshiwu, Shizandra. I have a section for male health, testosterone and hormones, and a section for female health, hormones and menses or menopause, etc.
And libido and everything.
And libido.
I can really recommend these herbs. They've helped me loads. My favorites overall for me and my clients have been Hoshiwu, Shizandra, Ashwagandha, and
Maca.
And Maca.
Maca is amazing. My favorite herb at the moment for overall everything, including your best for your endocrine gland hormonal system. Brilliant for menses, menopause, and female and male hormonal health and libido. Yeah. Really good extract I have in my shop, and I also have other stuff like Tonkatali, the most powerful like testosterone boosting herb in the planet. Super good. It's also really good for females if they're low on testosterone too. It's perfectly good for females, but brilliant for men also. And I have a thing called Flow, which is capsules, which increases flow naturally, healthfully to man's part, and they can have much better, if they have any erectile dysfunction, like they can have much better, like longer, harder type of idea. So body, mind, spirit, like nothing wrong with like sharing the whole like physical diet and herb aspect. So
yeah, herbs can definitely improve. And if you also have any history of sexual trauma or otherwise, I can help you remove layers of trauma in your energy bodies through my work. And and also stretch out your etheric body so that you're able to feel yourself more and better, and also stay more present, alert, and in your senses. You'll feel more, you'll sense more, and be able to receive more pleasure as well. So
yeah, he's like super like talented, like awesome energy healer. I really like, but more than that, like he's a guy living from a balanced divine masculine and divine feminine with an amazing good heart. Like I only like to recommend people with like a pure heart, as much as, like, I don't like to recommend too many people, but he's like my soul brother, and I trust him, and he's got no like hidden agendas, like an honorable man who tries his best, humble, so like totally recommend him. And
we would love to help you with any of our knowledge, wisdom, and energy and consciousness and experiences, not to say the least, because we've both struggled a lot in our lives.
Yeah, we've had hard, very hard lives early on,
Yeah, so it, we didn't come here easily.
This is
not easily bought. It's not come from a workshop in...
Or an easy life.
Paid in a way. We've paid our dues with hard-earned...
Oh, yeah.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, tears, and feeling the lowest of lows. The sickest of sick, and not wanting to live anymore, too. Or more.
Being fed up with life, and being fed up with being me. And now I enjoy life, I enjoy being me, I enjoy the company that I attract, the loving people that I align with, heart-based people that share openly their own wounds and expose themselves in order to lead the way or help others or create a new path where there were no paths before.
A new paradigm, a new earth, we're all creating it together.
Yeah.
And the one last thing I forgot to mention in the other earlier part of the video is good sex comes also from how your relationship is when you're not having sex. So basically the intimacy, bond and love and connection that you have just living daily life, that totally comes in waters into your whole sex life and in the bedroom or in nature, it's even better.
It doesn't matter how much of a connection you have to your partner either if you have a bad connection to yourself. So... connect with yourself as much as possible. Know thyself, be thyself, and love thyself, as we talked about earlier.
I love that, so powerful.
And that's the way to go. Seek solitude, even in a relationship, because you need to charge your own self, and you need to have that harmonious space within you first, and then bring it to your partner. I had a lot of difficulty with this due to my abandonment issues from childhood. And once I healed my emotional body, healed my pain body, and started meditating and doing the work that I'm doing now, everything changed for me, and now I'm content with being on my own. I'm content not being in a relationship.
Yeah, me too.
And I have a good relationship to myself and the people around me as a result of having a good connection to spirit source and my own energy and my own self.
Yeah. Love your gender sex and love the opposite sex too. Value and appreciate and be comfortable with both. And I just want to finally...
If you're a man and you've never complimented another man before, I challenge you here and now to compliment and appreciate the beauty of other men.
Yeah, even the sexualness as well, to a degree, for sure. Like, whatever you feel comfortable and genuinely true about.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Don't be so hung up, And one other thing I want to say is this video, apart from us recommending each other, I'd also just, you don't have to go to us, but I really want to encourage you to get help, healing, or support of anybody, even in your local community.
Yeah.
It's nothing to do with us. It's about you. This video is about you, and it's about us as well to a degree, of course, but it's not about trying to necessarily you have to come to us. You don't. You just go to anyone you want and
We're trying to present options to you here, and...
Because we're nice people.
We're not in a competition mindset.
Nah.
The people that are meant for us will come to us anyways.
Yeah.
So we believe in abundance.
Yeah.
And there is an abundance of people needing help on this planet.
Oh, yeah.
And if you're one of them, then you should definitely seek that help and not be afraid to ask for healing. Do not be afraid to reach out to someone who might... be in a better position than you.
Yeah, yeah.
Or otherwise.
Bless those more abundant than you, and that'll help you to become aligned with more abundance coming your way.
Yeah. If you're jealous in competition and in scarcity mindset,
shame on you.
Just kidding. Then that are the results that you will produce. You'll produce more of that energy, more to be jealous of, more scarcity.
Yeah.
And your healing will evade you.
Yeah. So. Give praise, love, and blessings, and at the same time, try acknowledge the truth of your own jealousy or envy, and just try and gradually make a little shift and open your heart a little bit more, and trust that goodness, more goodness will come to you in time as you keep living your life and being a practical manifester, living in alignment with the spiritual big picture.
The more you are aligned with yourself, the more you'll align with everything that's meant for you as well. Don't worry about it. It'll all come to you, what is meant for you. Just walk your path and strive to become a better person for you and the world. That's all it's about.
And be really glad for others having a really good, what you think is a good sexual relationship. Yeah. Sometimes what you think others are so blessed with, they have lots of turmoil and bad, like hard things happening in their life that we don't know about. So never be jealous or envious of any of us or anybody. Like, just try not to, at least. Like, I used to be like jealous and envious, like, or whatever the word would be, one or the other, jealousy or envy of other people who had more money than me. I was struggling, blah blah blah. But like, at the end of the day, just eventually let go of that over time. Like, give yourself time and be gentle on yourself and other people.
I had a belief system that money didn't grow on trees, that money was evil, that only stingy, greedy people had money. But as I've come to grow and learn spiritually, I see that abundantly healthy, beautiful, heart-centered people will have all that they need and more, so that they also can be able to give more to others and open up to receiving and open up to giving.
It's,
you're actually allowing someone to give their gift by receiving from them, allowing yourself to receive, you're allowing them to give.
In all areas of life.
Yeah.
But one last thing I'd probably like to say is, one, Ulf and I are both working and trying to do our contribution to the planet through doing healing and like coaching or like consultations with people, energy work and like just overall type of life.
My favorite herbalist in the world.
I have a herb shop, and so check out anyway our websites and our work, our services, how we could help you or how we could help any of your family members or loved ones who you think might resonate, or if we could help or they'd resonate with us. So check us out below, befriend us on Facebook. I'd like to thank you for any shares, support, comments, likes, or any type of like support or friendship or positive energy. Thanks very much.
And for watching, and we both hope you've got something good out of this.
Big time.
And enjoyed us having fun together on a video.
We love each other, we're soul brothers.
I watched his videos in 2010, 2011 when I was really sick, and I got my health back. I've
he's kicked
had
ass.
Loads and loads and loads of improvement from his herbal recommendations, and I really recommend his wisdom and love and care, because he loves what he does, and he's amazing at what he do. And I've gotten loads of, like, my hair, for example. He recommended an herb for me, and it's helped me regain my vitality and overall. Cosmetic stuff as well is amazing with that too.
Yeah,
so check him out.
And Ulf does brilliant like energy work and like Reiki and meridian energetics. Like, he's a fantastic, like, very talented, third eye very open, wise, loving, heart-centered man. So check out his website. I believe it's twinrayreiki.com.
Yeah,
I am higherselfherbs.com and owenfox.org. And thanks again for all your love and support and
we'd
everything
love to
you
help
do.
You.
And I really hope from our hearts that this like video helped, and I hope you enjoyed your time with us and our time with you. I hope you have the best sexual life, personal, like, body relationship with yourself, life, everything, friendships, family, work, creativity and passion. Just a really good life, basically speaking.
Abundance, health and wealth.
Yeah.
In all areas.
And thank you so much to the camera lady who was like looking after the camera. This is Zumi, my beautiful, beloved partner. I really pay my respect and honor to her too for being a part of this video. She's being an invisible part of this video. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.